In this video, we are going to discuss about principles of management. Management principles are nothing but the concepts which recommends management strategies. They may include tools such as frameworks and guidelines that can be implemented in modern organizations. In this video, we are going to discuss about the important principles given by Henry Foyle. Henry Foyle was a French mining engineer. He was a mining executive, author, and director of mines who developed general theory of business administration. This is also often called as Foyleism. When he was 19 years old, he began working as an engineer at a large mining company in France. He eventually became the director at a time when the mining company employed more than 1,000 people. Through the years of his experience, Foyle began to develop what he considered to be the 14 most important principles of management. Essentially, these principles explained how managers should organize and interact with staff. Foyle's 14 principles was one of the earliest theories of management to be created and remains one of the most comprehensive principles. So these are the 14 principles of Henry Foyle: division of work, authority, discipline, unity of command, unity of direction, order, scholar chain, centralization, remuneration, interest, equity, stability, initiative, and esprit de corps. The first principle of Henry Foyle is division of work. So division of work is also called as division of labor and specialization. So this is a principle of specialization, which is very well expressed by economists as being a necessary factor for efficiency in the utilization of labor. Division of work means to divide or break up a single complicated job into different smaller specialized tasks. When all smaller tasks complete as expected, they all together help to accomplish the single complicated job. So this is the principle of work allocation and specialization. So in order to concentrate activities to enable specialization of skills and understandings and more work focus and efficiency, this principle is very, very important. The next principle of Henry Foyle is authority and responsibility. So these are the two key things in management, that is authority and responsibilities. They work hand in hand. While authority enables the management to delegate work, responsibility makes them accountable for any work done under their leadership. Henry Foyle said that the power of authority accompanying responsibility gives the management the right to order subordinates along with a duty to be liable for acts of their subordinates. If responsibilities are allocated, then the post holder needs the requisite authority to carry these out, including the right to require others in the area of responsibility to undertake duties. So authority and responsibility are very, very important in effective management. The next principle is discipline. So the generalization about discipline is that discipline is very essential for the smooth running of any organization or business. So nothing good was ever achieved without discipline. The third principle propagated by Henry Foyle is discipline. It is one of the core values in any system. Good behavior and civilized interactions make the management work smoothly and efficiently. Good conduct by employees also helps them smoothly progress in their careers. The next principle is unity of command. So it basically means following a chain of command. A person should ideally answer to just one boss. If an employee is given work from so many superiors, that is more than one boss, there arises a conflict of interest. This can lead to confusion among the employees and hard to pin accountability. Thus, it is very crucial to follow unity of command. The next principle is unity of direction. For any manager to prosper, there must be an unified goal. This principle is crucial as it incorporates the idea of a workforce working a singular direction with a unified aim. The responsibility of planning falls on the manager, and he also must monitor the progress towards the said goal. That means every employee should receive instructions from one superior only, and the unity of command idea of having one head with agreed purposes and objectives and one plan for a group of activities. So the work will be clear. The employee also will feel comfortable in working with one boss. The next principle is subordination of individual interest. The standard rules for any organization is the work on the collective interests of the organization as a whole rather than personal interests of an individual. When working in an organization, all the individual interests must be subordinated. All the employees must work towards achieving a common goal. This principle states that the interests of an individual will be subordinate to the objective of the organization. This applies to the entire chain of command in the organization. The next principle is remuneration. We all love an appreciation for our efforts. Remuneration in an organization plays as a motivational force that keeps the employees fueled to do well. So this remuneration should be in tandem with the efforts that they put in. According to the activities, according to the qualification and skill of an employee, appropriate remuneration should be given. So remuneration may be monetary or non-monetary. At the end, the employee must feel that he was appropriately rewarded for his efforts. The next principle is centralization. Centralization refers to the practice of having decision-making authority at the top management or the executive board level. Henry Foyle explained the process of sharing this decision-making authority with the lower levels of management as decentralization. So now, how big or small the organization may be, there must be a balance between the two forms of decision-making, that is between the top level as well as lower level. The next principle is scalar chain. Every organization must possess a clear-cut hierarchy starting from the senior management to the lowest level in the organization. There should be a clear line in the area of authority from the top level to the bottom level management. This way, each employee must be able to contact a manager at the top level without challenging the hierarchy. Order. According to this principle, there should be a proper order for everything. The right resources for the employees help them to function properly in an organization. In addition to the responsibility of the managers, there must be a safe, clean, and tidy working environment. According to Foyle, in every organization, two different orders are necessary. They are material order and social order. Material order specifies that there should be a proper place for all physical resources, whereas social order specifies that there should be a proper place for all human resources in accordance with their designations. The next principle is stability of tenure of personnel. So this principle of management represents deployment and managing of personnel, and this should be in balance with the service that is provided from the organization. Management strives to minimize employee turnover and to have the right staff in the right place. Focus areas such as frequent change of position and sufficient development must be managed well. So time is needed for every employee to adapt to his or her work and performance. So it stability of tenure promotes loyalty to the organization, its purposes and values. So the next principle is equity. So this principle says that the managers should treat their subordinates in a just and kind manner so that they develop a feeling of dedication and attachment for their work. So all the employees should be treated equally and impartially. So managers should be fair to staff at all times, both maintaining discipline as well as necessary and acting with kindness wherever it is appropriate. That means all the employees, whoever is working in the organization, must be treated with equal equally and impartially. The next principle is initiative. According to Foyle, workers should be encouraged to develop and carry out their plans for improvement. Initiative refers to the it is the first step taken by the employees towards their self-motivation. So this principle states that employees at all levels should be given freedom to some extent so that they can come forward and use their skills to achieve expected goals. So at all levels of organizational structure, enthusiasm and energy will be enabled. It will help the people to work towards achievement of the organizational goals. The next principle is Esprit de Corps. According to Foyle, management should promote a team spirit of unity and harmony among all the employees. In order to achieve organizational objectives, management should promote teamwork and coordination. The feeling of I should be replaced with we in the managers while having a conversation with the workers. Esprit de Corps refers to the team spirit, that is the harmony in work group and mutual understanding among workers. It helps to develop an atmosphere of mutual trust and understanding. It also concentrates on famous saying, that is unity is strength. So this Esprit de Corps also helps the employees to develop interpersonal relationships. So these are the principles given by Henry Foyle. Thank you.